So we have already seen circuit analysis using two methods, that is nodal method and loop method, and we have seen this example and we have done this example using those two methods. Now I'm taking the same example and I'm trying it with another method which I call parallel cells method. Okay, so here I'll be using two batteries which are connected in parallel. Their EMF and internal resistance will be given, and these two batteries which are connected in parallel I can write as an equivalent battery with E0 and R0 as the resultant EMF and resultant internal resistance. Okay, so this resultant EMF is given as E1 R2 plus E2 R1 divided by R1 plus R2, and this internal resistance equivalent or equivalent internal resistance is given as R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. So this derivation we will take up in some other video. Let's see the application of this derivation in this particular question. So question was, we have to find current in this branch. Okay. So whenever such kind of situation is there, what you can do is you can take the other two branches and you can club as if two batteries are there. So here you can assume that here we have two batteries. This is its EMF. This is its internal resistance. Similarly, this is the another battery. 5 volt will be its EMF and 10 ohm will be its internal resistance. Okay. So what I can do is I can just redraw this diagram for better understanding. I can write it like this. So this is 20 volt, 20 ohms, and I can just exchange these two branches because it will not make any difference in the diagram, but it will just look little nicer. So this will be 5 volt, this is 10 ohms, and the third branch will be this one, 20 ohms. So I want current in this branch. Okay, so now what I can see is I want current in this branch. So these two batteries, I can say that these are connected in parallel, and instead of these two batteries, what I can do is I can write equivalent EMF and equivalent internal resistance, okay, which is E0 and R0. Now once I've written this, now my problem is very, very simple. And easily I can find what will be this current. Directly I can say current will be nothing but E0 divided by total resistance, which will be R0 plus 20. Okay. So all I need to find is E0 and R0 using this formula. Okay. So here what will be E0? So E0 will be this 20 into 10. Okay. Suppose this is R1, so I have to, this is E1, so I have to multiply with R2. Okay. And this is E2, so I have to multiply with R1. Okay, so 20 into 10 plus, this will be 5 into 20 divided by R1 plus R2, which will be 30. So this will be, this is 200 plus 100, 300 by 30, which will be 10. Okay, similarly R0 will be what? This will be 20 R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. So I can write over here 20 into 10 divided by 20 plus 10, which is 30. So this is 20 by 3. Okay. So now I can replace the values of E0 and R0 in this situation here. So I'll get as E0 is what? 10 divided by R0 is 20 by 3 plus this 20 ohms. Okay. So let's quickly solve this. This is very simple calculation. 20 I can take common. So this will be 1 plus 1 by 3, which will be 4 by 3. Okay, this will be cancelled, so this is nothing but 3 by 8. Same answer which we got using the other two methods. Okay, right. Now if somebody asks you, suppose you want current in some other branch, because here see, our the procedure was based on that I want current in this branch. So what I did is I clubbed these two branches. Okay, now suppose in the same question, if somebody asks you what will be current in this branch. Okay. So what you can do is you can club these two batteries, but now you may ask question that here we don't have any EMF. So if you don't have any EMF, what you do is you take a battery of zero EMF, okay, and then apply the same result. Okay. Similarly, if you want current in this branch, so what you do is you club these two branches, okay, and here again no battery is there, so you take its EMF to be zero and you apply the same formula, you will get the same result. Okay. So using the, see, this method is useful if in the question you want current in only one of the branch. Okay, because suppose you want current in all three branches. So now using this method, it will be quite difficult. Okay, as compared to nodal method. So it is based on the given question which method you have to use. Okay, this method is useful if they are asking the question current in any one of the branches. So if they are asking current in that one branch, what you do is the other two branches you will just combine using parallel cells method. Okay, thank you.